Intel released the NUC a few years ago, NUC being next unit of computing, and it's for machines that are less than 4 inches by 4 inches in size. Over the years they've revised the design and improved the specs, plus other manufacturers have made their own versions. One of the first out of the blocks was Zotac with their ZBOX, which now encompasses a range of machines from the tiny Atom processor-based ZBOX Pico, through to larger machines that support dedicated GPUs. Neither of those extremes met my needs, but their Nano C range, which have no fan whatsoever so they're completely silent, something else I value, would be perfect as they're tiny and inexpensive but well featured. Let's take a closer look. The ZBOX C series is available in several specifications, the main difference being the processors running from dual-core Celerons through to dual-core Core i5s or Core M's. This is the $150 ZBOX CI323 Nano. It was launched at the tail end of 2015 and contains a 5th generation quad-core Celeron processor running at 1.6 GHz, with the ability to turbo boost up to 2.06. It's a bare-bones system, which means you have to add your own RAM and hard drive. It can take up to 8 GB of RAM via its two SODIMM slots, and has room inside for a single 2.5-inch laptop hard drive or SSD. For the memory, I use this 8 GB Kingston HyperX kit, which was $35. I had a spare 250GB Samsung Pro 840 SSD drive, so I saved some money there. But you can buy a 250GB SSD for under $60 at the moment, so the as-tested configuration here is under $250. If you're not tech-savvy, don't be put off. You can buy plus versions of these Z-boxes which have memory and SSDs already fitted. But it's super easy to do yourself. It's not like building a whole PC. The bottom is held on by 4 rubberized screws that also act as the feet. You can even open them by hand if you can squeeze them tightly enough. And with that out of the way, you can see the two memory slots. Just put the memory sticks in, making sure you put them in the right way around. They're keyed, which is to say that there's a little notch that means they'll only go in one way. Insert them at a 45 degree angle, push inwards, and then push down flat until you hear a click. As I said, you can use any 2.5 inch laptop hard drive or SSD. Simply unscrew the bracket and set the two screws aside. They give you 2 more screws in the box. Use these to attach the bracket to the drive on the opposite end to the connector, then plug the drive into the connector and screw the bracket back down. Put the cover back on, and you're done. In terms of ports, they do vary between models, but the CI323 has, on the back, one HDMI 1.4 port, one display port, and strangely one VGA port. You also get 2 USB 2 ports, one USB 3 port, 2 1 gigabit Ethernet ports, a connector for a range-boosting wireless antenna, they give you one in the box, for the built-in 802.11ac wireless card, and of course the DC power input for the included brick. On the front, you get 2 USB 3 ports for convenience, one of which uses the latest Type-C connector, plus an SD card reader, microphone and headphone ports, which can also handle optical output via the included adapter, and an infrared receiver. The IR receiver seems like an unusual addition until you realise that they also include a VESA bracket for this machine, which lets you mount it to the back of your TV, out of sight. Before installing the OS, I decided to update the BIOS firmware. I highly recommend doing this, as Zotac updates the firmware very regularly, and there seem to be lots of bugs that they've ironed out at this point. Then I downloaded the latest Ubuntu Mate release, which is Beta 2 for the upcoming 16.04 long-term support edition. From the power on beep to the password prompt took around 17 seconds, with the desktop fully loaded and ready to go 10 seconds later. I ran the updater, then installed the latest Intel graphics driver. I don't know if this was necessary, but it didn't appear to cause any harm either. In use, the machine feels very responsive, driving my 3440 by 1440 ultra-wide panel at sadly only 50Hz versus my preferred 60, but watching 1080p YouTube videos expanded to full screen results in no dropped frames. 1440p YouTube videos in full screen struggle a bit, and 4K videos are really not an option. Although this machine is not for gamers, I then installed Dota 2 just for kicks, and while it wasn't smooth, it was playable. So what do I think? All in all, I don't think you can ask much more of a $250 device that's this small and uses so little power. On idle, it consumes 6 watts, which is about as much as one RAM stick in my full-size desktop. No, it's not for gamers. Nothing with integrated graphics is. There are larger and pricier Z-boxes for that, and video editors would also want something more powerful. But for the rest of us, for normal computer use, it's a nice machine that provides the specs of some $600 laptops for only $250. Just supply your own screen, keyboard and mouse. As long as you're not gaming or doing heavy content creation, the Zotac ZBOX CI323 Nano definitely gets my recommended rating. If you found this review helpful, let me know by hitting the like button and dropping me a comment. And check out some of my other reviews and how-tos, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any future videos.